Many college soccer teams look to fill out the rosters with international students, and this is a trend that's not going away anytime soon. In fact, during the 2016 and 2017 period, there were about 40,000 college men's soccer players in the US. Of these 40,000 players, 3,000 of them were international recruits. Therefore, international recruits account for 23% of men's soccer college roster spots in the D2 and in the D1 level. So basically, in this video, I'm gonna be talking to you guys about how to put yourself in the best position as an international student to get yourself a scholarship in the United States. So step number one, I've said this a lot of times in my previous videos, and this is making a soccer recruiting video. This is one of the most important steps as an international athlete to take in the recruiting process, so family should make sure it's done well. Yes guys, coaches in the US do prefer to watch athletes in person, but they also watch a lot of recruiting videos when it comes to evaluating an athlete. So coaches might travel far away to watch you internationally. I know some coaches have done that before, but it's not really known, so you gotta make sure that your video is ready and you can send it out to them whenever you need to. You know, when you compare it to a player that lives in America, it's a bit easier for them to interact with coaches in the same country. But for international athletes, you have to make sure that you're putting that extra attention into your video. That's what's really gonna showcase your skills when it comes to showing it to coaches. All right, step number two, you have to make sure you're doing your research ahead of time. International recruits don't have the luxury to hop in their car and go drive off a couple hours to the next city or the next state to see how the campus looks like. Many aspects of the recruiting and the college application process will be very difficult to find, so you must make sure that you're doing your research before time. You know, as an international, you must understand the different levels in American soccer. So for the NCAA, there's Division 3, there's Division 2, and there's Division 1, with Division 1 being the highest level. And there's the NAIA, which compares to the Division 2 level in the NCAA in many cases, and also the junior colleges. Each division level offers a unique college experience that can potentially be your right fit as an international student athlete. You must know that the NCAA and the NAIA have documentation requirements for international student athletes in order for them to compete. Also, as an international student, you must learn how it's like to live on a college campus. There are many factors that contribute to the college experience. That could be weather, that could be campus location, the campus diversity, and the facilities. And finally, you must become familiar with the types of scholarships that they have to offer in the NCAA and in the NAIA. Factors such as division level and athletic talent determine whether or not you're gonna get a full scholarship or a partial scholarship. Some schools that don't offer athletic scholarships will actually come up with a different way to help families in finding a second resource and, you know, financial aid or some other type of scholarship funds. Now for number three, you must review your academic eligibility requirements. Like I said, the NCAA and the NAIA have specific documentation requirements in order for international student athletes to be academically eligible to compete in sports. So whether you're interested in Division 1 or playing in Division 2, you must review the academic requirements. So you're gonna have to provide academic records for years 9 and up in English and in your native language. You're gonna have to provide your proof of graduation, including your certificates, diplomas, and final exams. You'll have to take the ACT or the SAT test and send your scores to the NCAA. I know in my circumstance, I came from a little JUCO in Canada, so I didn't have to take those tests. I kind of just had to send my transcripts and my records over, and then it worked out that way. You also have to find out about country-specific requirements and documentation. And one of the most important things is the Form I-20. This is provided by the NCAA schools. So that means you'll have to work with the interested school to get your F1 visa. And you have to understand, for the F1 visa, it has specific requirements for eligibility. And it will also be important to learn different requirements for the NAIA schools. So for the NAIA guys, you must register at the NAIA Eligibility Center at least 2 months before you start classes at the NAIA school. You must also take the ACT or the SAT test and send your scores to the NAIA using the code 9876. And you must send your high school or your post-secondary university records to the NAIA. And make sure guys that you're translating all your records to English, because I know some of you international students might speak a different language and English might be your second language, so just make sure everything is in English before you send them out. And somewhere on the screen here guys, I'm gonna put up the NCAA and the NAIA requirements, the type of documents you need, eligibility, and just all that good information so you guys can really look at it yourself. And finally guys, for tip number four, make sure you start early and you're proactive with communication. I can't stress this enough. If you want to come as an international and you want to come play in the United States, you have to be a standout. So you got to make sure that you're going in with everything you got. So be communicative, talk a lot, be proactive with your coaches, you know, keep a good relationship moving forward. You have to understand that coaches in the US start filling the roster spots right away to make sure that they don't lose their top recruits. So it's important to be proactive and start reaching out to coaches early on. When you write emails, guys, make sure that they're unique to the specific program, because coaches read a lot of emails, they get a lot of emails, and they're quick to discard generic ones. So if your email is boring and short and it's just bang average, chances are a coach is gonna quickly discard it. So make sure that you're putting a lot into those emails and you're just trying to really be a standout. Also, as an international student, it's tough to make a first impression. You know, we have to make first impressions on the way we talk to them or the way we send their emails or the way we make our videos. So you gotta make sure that you're doing a really good job at that. So a potential way to grab a coach's attention is explaining exactly why you wanna be there and you wanna be at that program. And here's an important one: do not bring up money first. Build a relationship, be proactive, and work it that way first before you start asking for a scholarship and how much he's willing to offer you. You don't want to be that guy that lost his opportunity because he was money hungry. You know what I mean? Money will come, but at first you must build a proper relationship with the coach before you can start asking for those things, because if they see that all you want is money and a scholarship, then they might think that you're using them. And finally, guys, always include the newest version of your CV video, because for us internationals, the only way a coach is going to see us play is through our video. So always make sure that your video showcases your athletic talent and your skills along with the CV to make sure it's very professional and it stands out amongst others. So basically, guys, that's it for today's video on how to get a scholarship as an international student and, you know, how to play overseas. So if you guys have any other questions or concerns, please comment down below or message me in my DMs. I'll be happy to help you guys. But other than that, please make sure you like and subscribe to this video, and I'm gonna catch up with you guys tomorrow. Thank you so much. Peace out.